days are surely
coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill my promise and will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land.
Lord, we lift our eyes to you, the God of the heavens, as we live in this world full of conflict, pain, and suffering. We long for the day when you will come to reign with justice, love, and peace. As the Lord lived among us, he gave us this promise, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am also. So as we seek to worship in this place, we know the Lord is here with the spirit of glory, truth, and grace.
Thank you.
And now we join to remember the night when God came to earth through the birth of the baby.
From the Gospel of Luke, we read those timeless words which lead us to the manger.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
As we hear these miraculous words, we are inspired to bow in worship and bring our gifts of praise to the Holy Christ Child. Suddenly found themselves in the presence of heaven's angels. As the angels shared the glorious news of Christ's birth, their quiet night was instantly changed into an unforgettable experience.
And the angels said to them, "Fear not, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord."
Thank you.
in the presence of the newborn king. They traveled many miles and endured much difficulty, simply to bow before him and to offer him gifts of adoration.
Listen to the Magi as they call us to rise and follow. Come and worship. Worship the newborn king. Treasured the beautiful memories of her newborn and how they must have brought her joy and sometimes comfort, especially in the difficult days she would experience through Jesus' life.
As Mary treasured these things, so we treasure our Christmas memories. We hold dear our stories and the loved ones from our past who still live in our hearts.
When we remember these people and share the love they gave to us, still they are here. Still, they are here at Christmas time.
We come to worship in the Christmas season, friends and family, all around.
together we've called for God's presence to reign in our world. We've shared the true Christmas story when the Holy Child came to earth.
We have worshiped in the presence of God's Spirit. We have remembered people who've shared their gifts of love and are still present in our hearts.
Now we must live to be the Christmas presence, to share with our world the hope, peace, love, and joy of God's presence.
As we prepare to go into the world to share the gifts that God has placed within us, let us pray together the prayer that Saint Francis of Assisi prayed so long ago.
Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy.
Thank you. we certainly would like to thank our choir and guests, our home musicians and guests, and especially all of you.